Are you still married? Do you have kids? I have two kids and I'm still married. In fact, we just celebrated our 18-year anniversary 2 weeks ago or so. Is it 18, right? Why do Excel coaches on YouTube have ASMR-like voices? We didn't choose to sound like this. I think it's years of explaining the same formulas give you that type of sound. Plus, if you fall asleep during my videos, it's good for the YouTube algorithm, right? It's been a while since our last Q&A. Now that we're approaching 3 million subscribers, which is crazy, it's a perfect time to do another one. You sent in your questions, let's go. What's the translation of your name, Leila? I believe it means night, but I'm not 100% sure. So if you know it, let me know. What hobbies do you have and what do you do to relax and wind down? I like to work out, mainly weight training. I just try not to lose too much muscle mass, given my age. I've also taken on range shooting. We go to the range once a week, a great way to turn off my mind. What made you pick Austria versus the US with a better entrepreneurial environment? We don't have a tech startup, so I think you can start this business from wherever you are. Austria is where I was during my teen years. It's a great place to be. Great great healthcare, great education, it's green, it has culture, and I love living here. Do you get recognized while out and about in Austria? Occasionally, but not that often. Some weeks ago, we went, me and a friend of mine, we were having lunch at a restaurant, and the manager there was taking my courses. So that was really cool. And once I was walking the dog just around our place and someone in my VBA course recognized me. But yeah, it's rare. What is your favorite board game if you have any? Backgammon. Do you have a stylist? No. Do you think I need one? No, actually I did hire a stylist because I don't really know what goes well together. I showed her my wardrobe. I showed her all my home clothes. And I asked her if she can mix and match them so I can wear them outside my home. Oh, and my daughter gives me great advice. So I bought her this set, which I thought looks ridiculous. But then I tried it on and I loved it. So now I wear that too. How did you turn to making tutorials on Excel? Where did the inspiration start? So I was in corporate for 14 years in finance, IT, project management. When I left corporate, the plan wasn't to do Excel. It was mainly to consult for Oracle Financial Management. That was the tool I was rolling out or working with for the past 10 years. I offered Excel consulting and training because that was something that the companies needed or the people that I knew, who knew me and knew that I was good in Excel, asked me to do. And I realized that was what I was more passionate about. So basically my side thing became my main thing. And there was no real master plan. I started doing online stuff later on because I wanted to teach in English. So I decided to take my offline trainings and bring them online. And it allowed me to reach a bigger audience. When did you start learning Excel and when did you become a master? So my first job was an economist in Canada. That's when I started to learn Excel. When I moved back to Austria and started to work in operations performance team, so I was like an in-house consultant, that's when I realized how little Excel I knew. I'm still learning. So in terms of the question, when did you become a master? I think a master knows that they're never really a master. There's always something to learn. How did you monetize your skill before YouTube videos? What was your vision? Yeah, so when I left corporate, the plan was to freelance. And I made money through consulting and training. My vision was to not work in corporate, but to teach. And it brought me here. If you could go back and give your younger self one piece of career advice, what would it be? That's a difficult one. So I spent a lot of time thinking that credentials were really important, thinking that experience, external validation, all of this is really important. I think I should have been confident a lot earlier, and that don't wait. Don't wait for external validation. Just go for whatever you want to do, and you're going to learn what you need to learn along the way. Also, don't take yourself too seriously. Which advice would you give to someone who has a talent and wants to use it as a way of living? Let me ask you this. Can you find someone else who has that talent and has made a living? Also, would you be willing to do the thing that you want to do if you weren't going to get paid for it for a few months? Depending on what you want to do, you know, sometimes like creating content, getting paid for your videos or getting paid for your online courses can take many, many months. You know, if you don't know how the process is because you've never done it, it's difficult to judge. The best way to know is if you do it. So start doing it and see how you feel, and then you're going to know. How tough a boss are you? I don't think I'm a tough boss. How tough am I? No one is commenting behind the scenes, so they're all agreeing with me. Next question. How many days does it take to prepare one YouTube video, and how many team members do you have? So we are 5 full-time, 1 part-time. A YouTube video, on average, depending on the topic, takes around 1 day prep, 1 day recording, and how many days to edit? 1 or 2 days? How many days? The cameraman is falling asleep. How many days? How many days does it take you to edit a YouTube video?
3 days.
Okay. 3 or 4 days with a thumbnail. So let's say on average it takes 5 days. Crazy, right? Just for like a 10-minute video. That's what it takes. Do you think you're the greatest MVP in the world? Looks like someone saw the video. I was just so happy to be a part of this amazing production. It was just like another level. And by the way, if you don't know what I'm talking about, you need to see the video. I was just a placeholder to annoy Giles, and I think I did the job pretty well. I don't mean to be a politician to like avoid the question, but I don't wear my cape in my free time. Force people to carry my flag. Speaking as an Excel coach myself, are we going to be okay in this new AI era? That's something that's on all our minds right now. I think coaches are going to be more important because businesses need help in how they can use AI alongside all the other tools that are getting updates as well. We're all bombarded with new features. It's important as a coach, as a trainer, to understand these features, to see the different ways they can be helpful, and to guide businesses on how to use these features. And I think as a coach or trainer, we should include AI in our training as well. So this is something we did with our Python course. I teach the basics, and then I teach how you can use AI to become better, faster. So yeah, we're going to be okay as long as AI doesn't blow us all up. What's your take on Copilot? Copilot has great potential. If you've seen my Copilot videos, you know what I'm talking about. But when Copilot first rolled out, it was as if you had a 4-year-old kid preparing your dinner. It wasn't something you wanted to consume. Right now, I would say Copilot is like a teenager. It has good days and bad days. It can leave a huge mess. It can drive you nuts. But soon, it's going to become an adult. And it's going to be pretty reliable. That's what I'm looking forward to. With the rise of AI, will tools like Excel still play a central role in business workflows? Yeah, businesses want a reliable tool. They want backward compatibility. A lot of businesses open files that they created years ago. And Excel is one of those tools that you can open a file from 20 years ago and you're still going to see the same numbers. So Excel is one of those rare tools that balances reliability with modern updates. As a beginner BI analyst, what are the core skills that will remain relevant no matter what technology comes next? I would say core skills to have, no matter how the tools we use change, would be logical thinking, curiosity. I don't know if that's a skill, but stay curious. If you are a data analyst, understand why you are analyzing what you're analyzing. Be able to see the bigger picture and communication skills. In a lot of companies, people like to use sophisticated words to seem sophisticated. But if you want to be remembered, use simple words. I'm a chartered accountant who wants to do something like you. Help people with Excel as side income. What would you suggest? I would say start with whatever you're struggling with as a chartered accountant and how you overcame that struggle. Go on social media if that's what you're drawn to. Make YouTube videos. Do consulting if that's what you prefer, if you prefer to work one-on-one. Basically start with what you feel drawn to, what you think helps people that are in your situation, and see if you enjoy it. Because doing something is different than thinking about doing it. When you start doing it, you might not like it. Just try it out. As a finance professional who wants to transition into data analytics, what's the best path? I'd say you're already halfway there, because as a finance person, you already know what the numbers mean. So if you combine your expertise together with the tools that make reporting a lot easier, which is Power Query, Power Pivot, so Excel's data model, and Power BI, then you're all set. Ooh, my favorite. How do you master Excel? Okay, so here is the formula. You ready? Learn it, use it, learn it, use it, learn it, use it, exactly in this structure. I would say once you've done this, once you follow this great formula, try to pick out one part of your process that you're doing, something that you're doing in Excel, and try to find five other ways of doing it. You'll be surprised at what you're going to find, and that might just open up another world, and you're going to go down different rabbit holes. But you're going to see that as you learn more about Excel, you're going to discover lots of things that you didn't know. How can someone from a non-IT background learn Excel perfectly like you? I don't have an IT background. I think 80%, I mean, I'm just making this up, but 80% of people who use Excel don't have an IT background. So you can learn Excel perfectly, like me. Not like me, because I'm the greatest MVP in the world, but yeah, you know, sorry. It's just, it just has to go. So yeah, you can learn Excel perfectly without an IT background. If you were to recommend one of your courses, no bundles, okay, to a person seeking career advancement, which one would it be? Power Query. Why? Because it doesn't matter what industry you work in. If you work with data, you're going to get messy data. And the tool that's going to help you clean that up is Power Query. Is VBA still worth learning? Ooh, so VBA is a great automation tool. I used it a lot in the past. It was generally used a lot in the past. Nowadays, IT is trying to move away from it. It doesn't work on the web. So a lot of companies that use Excel on the web, or they use Teams and they open their Excel files, they don't want to use VBA. So unless you really need it, or you need to maintain some VBA Excel files that were created in the past and you have to update them, then yeah. Otherwise, it's a difficult language to learn. Should I focus on Excel for data analysis or just Power BI only? Focus on both, because both are going to be relevant for a long time. Why are most people still unaware of Power Query when it's as powerful as a black hole pulling in messy data? I'd say Microsoft buried a treasure by calling it Power Query. It just scared the shit out of people. It also has the effect of turning away the audience from that tool because it sounds very complicated. It sounds like you have to have an IT background to work with it. I think if they just called it something simple like data cleanup wizard or data cleanup pro, it would just be more discoverable by a lot of people. What's the difference between your free YouTube content and your paid courses? So on YouTube, I have to be brief. I can go in depth up to a certain point. So for example, I've done videos like pivot tables in 10 minutes, and it's a great way of getting started with pivot tables, but our pivot table course has that lecture as a part of a bigger transformation, as a part of understanding how you can create pivot tables if your data is messy, understanding how you can embed pivot tables in dashboards. We also cover many different real life examples, because if you work in corporate, you know that things aren't as simple as you see on YouTube. So the difference is depth plus real life practice. You also get certificates. We also have teaching assistants that help you and guide you whenever you get stuck. Could you share a few of your note-taking techniques and tools? So I use OneNote for my personal note-taking. I actually have a video or two on that. Check out the cards or links in the description for those videos. And if I'm collaborating with my team, I use Loop. Final question. I saw your YouTube studio tour. Thank you for watching that. Do you have plans to make another lifestyle video? Not really. My life is a bit boring, I would say, but I might consider making an ASMR video. Would you like that? That's it. So these were the questions. We had over 500 questions sent in, so I'm sorry if I couldn't get to yours. We had a lot of Excel questions and technical questions as well that we're going to try and answer in our newsletter if it applies to a wider group of people. So sign up to our newsletter, Between the Sheets, that's what it's called. So if you haven't fallen asleep yet, thank you for being here, thank you for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video.